Let's have some fun and games with double or nothing. So, higher or lower? Part one, the game. Here's the game. We start off with a card. Here's an example that starts off with three. Would you like to change that card? No, let's keep it the same. So, higher than three. Nine, correct. Higher or lower than nine? Lower. Five. Oh, correct. Well done. Higher or lower than five? Higher. Queen. Let's move the queen up here. Now, you can change this card. Let's keep it. Queen's quite good. So, queen, higher or lower? Lower. Two. Great card. Higher than a two. King. Oh, good card. Lower than the king. Seven. Not so good. Let's move the seven. Ah, we can change this card. So shall we change it? Yes, a four. Okay, let's go for higher than a four. Six. Yes, we're a winner. Okay, now that was good. But now let's make it even more interesting by adding a stake. You can bet an amount of points and you get double or nothing. So let's have an example. Let's say you have 100 points in the bank and you've got a 5 and you say higher. So your bank was 100 and now you're going to have a bet of 30 points. So your stake is 30. So now your bank is 70. So your bank is 70. Oh, if you lose, then your bank is down from 100 to 70. But if you win, your stake is doubled. So your bank has increased to 130. So you're betting your stake. If you lose, you lose that amount of points. If you win, you double that amount. So let's see a demonstration. Okay, let's play the game. We start off with the bank. We're going to start off with a bank of 10. Our first card is a 10. So we're going to change that? No, we're going to keep it. Higher or lower than a 10? Lower. Enter the stake. We're going to bet 5. New card is ace, so we've lost 5. The bank is now 5. Lower than an ace, might as well bet everything. Yes, it's lower. So we've won. So our bank for 5 has now gone up to 10. Higher than a 4? Yes. Well done. Our bank is now 18. 7. Change a card? Yes. New card 10. Lower than a 10? Enter the stake? 8. Well done. Now 26 in our bank. Higher than a 2. Higher. Let's bet everything, shall we? Let's bet 20. Oh, okay. That's a winner. So 46. Higher than a 4. Let's bet 26. Okay, now. We've got 20 left in our bank. Keep a 3. Higher than a 3. Yes, and our stake, we might as well bet all 20. Oh no, it's another 3, so our bank is 0. We lost everything on the last card. Okay, let's play a game. So let's run the program. We're going to start off with a bank of 100 points. And we've got a 7. I think we'll change that to a 2. Oh great, let's go higher than a 2. How much are the 100? The whole lot. Great, we've got an ace, a bank of 200. Lower than an ace, bet the 200. Wow, we're up to a bank of 400 points. Higher or lower than a 6? Not so easy. Higher, 100. So we've lost 100 there. Now a 5, should we change that? If we put in a wrong value, it will give us our error message. So remember, yes or no. So if we put in L for lower, we'll just keep coming back with the message. So let's change the card to a 10, lower than a 10. How much for stake? 100. Okay, that's a winner. Back to 400 in the bank. Lower than a 9. Not good. A king. But king's a good card. So lower than a king. Let's bet. 350. Well done. Right, 700 on the last card. We've got a 3. Shall we bet the whole lot? Higher than a 3, 700. What's going to happen? Oh, it's a 3 again. Oh dear, we've lost all our money on the last card again. So what have we seen already? Well, in the previous video, we had a shuffled pack of cards. We converted it so we could play higher or lower. And at the end of the game, it was a winner or a loser. So what do we need now? Well, the game, we need to be able to change the card. Then we play higher or lower 3 times. Then the card moves up, so then we can change it again. Then we play higher or lower another 3 times. Then we can change the card if we wish again. And then the last higher or lower finishes the game. We also need a bank and stake. So when we loop, the user chooses higher or lower 3 times, and the user enters the stake. So we just need to calculate the new bank if it's a winner or a loser. So we do that 3 times, and then we do that 3 times again, and then we do that for the last card. So what's new here? Well, the game, we just really need to offer to change the card, and then we just repeat the higher or lower. The stake, we have the bank, the stake, and how the bank changes. So change card. Change card asks the user if they want to change. And if they do, we can just pop the pack of cards. If there's no change, we can just keep the same card as previously used. So here's not the complete code, but most of the code. So we have a function called offerChange, and if the user wants to change, we pop a card from our cards, and then we show that, we tell what the user is, and then we can return the new card plus the new pack of cards that has one card that's been popped. If they don't want to change, we can just return the same card that was used before and the cards as they were before. So we put that in a loop. The actual code, although that's quite a lot of code to look at, we can see here highlighted in red, we have the message for the user. Then we have to check the user puts in yes or no to if they want to change. If they do yes, then we deal with the new card, and no, we just return without the new card. So that's the change card code. So let's see that in action. We start off with the code from the last video. We had convert card, printed card, get cards, play card. So these are the same as we had before. The difference, we now offer to change the card. So let's go through this function. So we show the card, then we create a message that we ask the user, do they want to change it or not? Now, if they put in yes, then we're going to change the card. No, we don't change the card. Anything else, we're just going to repeat the message. So we have an error message saying you must enter Y for change or N for keep. We put that in a while loop. If they enter N, we just return the previous card. And if they select Y to change card, we create a new card by popping the stack, the shuffled cards, the list or shuffled cards, and then change the card to the new card. Now, because we've changed the stack, the list of shuffled cards, then we have to return that list as well. So we return the new card or the old card with the pack of cards. The only main difference apart from that for the game is we're going to play higher or lower three times in a sequence. So we offer the change to card. So offer the user, do you want to change the card? Then play three. We do that in a loop, so we do that twice. And at the end of the game, we just play higher or lower once. So that's quite straightforward. The second part that's new is the having the bank, having to bet a stake and changing the bank amount. So how do we do that? Well, we need to open the bank account so we can has choose your stake for how many points. So we've set these as 10, 100 or 1000. So the user chooses a bank account at the start. Now when the higher or lower is guessed, the user bets an amount. That's the stake. So we adjust the bank account. So once we adjust the bank account, we can determine if the higher or lower is correct or not. If it wasn't, we don't need to change anything more. And if there's a winner, we need to add the winnings. So let's have a look how we do that. We have to change the code in quite a few places to allow a bank and the user to bet amounts from this bank on each higher and lower. So let's start off at the beginning. So we ask at the start, you can choose your stake, 10, 100 or 1000 points. So that becomes the bank. So we tell the user what the bank is. So we get the cards as usual. So the first card, and now we have the first offer to change the card. So as we said previously, we had the offer to change a card, we play three, we offer to change a card, we play three, and then there's the final card at the end. So what do we need to do with the stake? So when we play, if you have a look at our function play card, we ask the user to choose between higher or lower, and we have an error message in case they don't enter that correctly. But now we also ask to enter the stake, and we have a message there as well to make sure they enter a correct stake. If you see here, if the stake is less than zero or the stake is over what the bank should be, then that won't work. So the stake has to be less than equal to the amount in the bank, and it has to be greater than zero. So once we've got the stake, then we can take away that amount from the bank. So once we see the new card, we know if it's correct or higher or lower. We can then work out the winnings, which is twice the stake, and then add them to the bank and show the user. Now if the guess was incorrect and it wasn't higher or it wasn't lower as the user wanted, then the bank will stay the same because we've already taken away the stake. So that means that when a card is played higher or lower, then the bank is calculated minus the stake and any winnings added on. So that happens during the loop when there's three card games, if you like, we play three higher or lowers in a sequence. That happens twice, and then at the end the card is just played once. Now if at any point the bank goes to zero, we need to come out of the loop because the user has to be able to put some of the bank in as a stake. So there's several parts in the code that you need to check to make sure the user enters the data correctly. But essentially that's all the code for the game. So let's go through that. We have the convert card, printed card, get cards, the same as the last video. The play card function is the same with the added code to get the stake from the user. That is taken away from the bank. Now, if the higher or lower is correct, then the amount is added to the bank times 2, double or nothing. And if it's not correct, then the bank stays the same with the stake reduced. In this game, we play higher or lower 3 times with a possibility of changing the card. So you can change the card if you wish. The user can change the card if they wish. Then we play 3 higher or lowers. Then we repeat that. You can change the card again. Play 3, and then the final card, offer a change, and then to play the card. And at the end, we tell the user how much the bank is. Thank you for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe.